Hey everybody, welcome back to the High Yield Video Question Bank series. Once again, this is the series of videos where I present you with tricky questions to help you train your brain to develop patterns of high yield thinking that would lend itself to dominating USMLE and COMLEX because your brain has already navigated through these high yield scenarios. In this video, we're going to be talking about rabies post-exposure prophylaxis. Admittedly, this is a topic that nobody loves studying. The guidelines and the recommendations for what you do for somebody who has been exposed or bitten by an animal is really complex, and it seems like it's difficult to memorize. But in this video, I'll present you with a practice question, go through the guidelines, and help simplify this for you, all for your studying pleasure. Let's get started. A 27-year-old male is bitten by a raccoon. The raccoon runs away after biting him. The patient goes to the local emergency department for medical clearance. The patient, at this time, has entirely normal vital signs. There is a roughly 2 centimeter laceration on the right hand where the raccoon bit the patient. There's minimal blood, no exposed tissue, and some small patches of dirt where the patient's hand contacted the ground. The patient is up to date on all vaccinations, including rabies. Which of the following is the correct recommendation at this time for post-exposure prophylaxis? A. Wound cleansing with a povidone iodine solution. B. Wound cleansing plus 2 doses of HDCV/PCEC vaccine. C. Wound cleansing plus 4 doses of HDCV/PCEC vaccine. D. Wound cleansing plus 2 doses of HDCV/PCEC vaccine plus rabies immunoglobulin. Or E, wound cleansing plus 4 doses of HDCV/PCEC vaccine plus rabies immunoglobulin. So pause the video if you'd like some time to think about this question before I start to explain the answer. Now if you're ready, I'm going to start to go through the answer. So let's look at the question and highlight what's important for you to get this answer correct. The really important high-yield bit of information in the question stem is bolded in red. It says that the patient is up to date on all vaccinations, including rabies. So we can presume from reading this question that in the past, the patient has already received the rabies vaccine. So they've already been vaccinated before. It doesn't matter why, but the question's telling you that they've already received the vaccine. Therefore, the answer to this question is B, wound cleansing with a povidone iodine solution plus 2 doses of the rabies vaccine. And you'll see the rabies vaccine written as HDCV/PCEC vaccine. Don't worry about what it stands for, but you'll obviously be able to infer from reading the question that they're talking about the rabies vaccine. So the question on your mind should be dirty. How was I supposed to get this question right? How am I supposed to know the guidelines for post-exposure prophylaxis of rabies? Well, let's transition and talk about really high-yield bits of information and simplify this to one simple flowchart. So when you're talking about rabies post-exposure prophylaxis, what you need to ask yourself, the first question, is did the patient ever get vaccinated before? Or in other words, what's their vaccination status? And you've really got 2 options, right? They've either been previously vaccinated or they've never been vaccinated. And depending on which of the two the patient falls into, that will adjust the recommendation. So if the patient previously received a rabies vaccine, it doesn't matter when, why, or how, you do wound cleansing plus 2 doses of the vaccine. If they've never been vaccinated, never ever received rabies vaccine, then you do wound cleansing plus 4 doses of the vaccine plus immunoglobulin. The goal here is that you give somebody immunoglobulin if they've never been vaccinated because you want their body to have a little bit of a protected state. Typically, it takes about 7 days from the time you get a rabies vaccine for your body to start to initiate the immunoglobulin response against rabies. So in somebody who's never been vaccinated, the reason that you give them immunoglobulin is to buy them a 7-day window during which the vaccine can start to do its thing and start to work, but the patient is still protected and still mounting an immune response in the 7 days where the vaccine is sort of warming up. That's why you give the immunoglobulin to somebody who's never been vaccinated. But if somebody's previously been vaccinated, then presumably they've already got some level of immunoglobulin response in their body to rabies. So you only have to give that patient two doses of vaccine. So the takeaway here is that previously vaccinated, two doses. Never vaccinated, four doses plus immunoglobulin. In both, you clean the wound, which should be fairly obvious. You're always going to clean somebody's wound off. Okay? So this is really all you need to know. This is it. So let's go back to the question. The patient was up to date on their vaccine, so we did wound cleansing plus two doses. Because they got rabies vaccine before, we didn't have to give them immunoglobulin. Now pretend for a second that the question said the patient has never been vaccinated. Well, in that case, what would the answer theoretically be? If that were the case, the answer would have been E, which I've shown here in green. So because they would have never been vaccinated against rabies, we would have had to not only clean the wound, but also give them four doses of the vaccine plus the immunoglobulin to buy them that 7-day window where the immunoglobulin can somewhat protect them while the vaccine is warming up and doing its thing. So again, the high yield bottom line and the takeaway from this practice question is right here on this slide. If they've gotten the vaccine, it's two doses of vaccine. If they've never gotten the vaccine, it's four doses plus immunoglobulin. And in any case, regardless of vaccine or not, you always cleanse the wound. That's it, guys. So if you can memorize this very simple flowchart, you'll never miss a question on rabies post-exposure prophylaxis. There's one more thing that I want to talk about just because it might come up on some really nitpicky questions. The next slide is going to be slightly lower yield, so if your brain is already stressed for space, turn off the video now. But if you're shooting for that 270, hang tight because I got one more thing to tell you. Very rarely, these questions can pivot and go in a different direction, either through like part two of the question, a follow-up question, or this could just be an entirely unrelated question. But since we're talking about rabies, I want to put one slide in here about pre-exposure vaccination. So I have seen this come up and I want to mention it because they don't talk about this in medical school, so it's got to be somewhere and I'm going to give it to you here. So the question is, when should you preemptively go to your doctor and get a pre-exposure vaccination? That is, under what conditions should you go to your doctor and be like, hey, I think I need the rabies vaccine because of something I'm about to do. So who falls into that category? Well, here's what qualifies. If you're traveling to a country with widespread rabies, you should get the vaccine before you go. If you're doing some activity that will bring you into contact with either domestic or wild animals, you should get the vaccine. And typically on exams, this will be a biologist, a veterinarian, or an agricultural specialist. If you're traveling to a remote area where medical care is limited or might be delayed if you need it, such as going hiking or on, you know, some exotic trip where you're going through villages, you want to get the vaccine. And if you're planning to stay more than 1 month in an area where dog rabies is common, you want to get the vaccine. So if you're going to be going on any of these trips, or the patient in the vignette is going on any of these trips, then they need pre-exposure vaccination of the rabies vaccine. Now that's it, guys. I've now given you the post-exposure prophylaxis and the pre-exposure vaccination prophylaxis. I hope that this was helpful to you. These questions do come up, especially on step 2, level 2, all the damn time. So please know them because it's free points on test day.